Go ahead.
Well, the astrology, for a lot of people always wonder and ask me, like, what's going on? Are we going to have a full collapse again astrologically? What's the deal? The truth is by 2024, Pluto will finally leave Capricorn. Capricorn is the sign that represents our structural system of government and financial systems and so forth. They will keep it going as long as they can, till the very end. And people think that some crazy thing's going to happen, or the Iraqi dinar is going to save the day, or all these things. I will give you guys my astrological truth. We've got another, it's 2017. I mean, this is like another 7 years. It's not going to go bad. Before, it's going to get a little weird. It's going to get a little weird in 2020 because we're going to have the triple conjunction with Saturn, Jupiter, Pluto. Okay. That's in 2019 and 20. There'll be some sort of other big repair. Okay. But this thing is not just going away. So don't be freaking out and being like, I'm getting off the grid and I'm going to go here right away. Cause you'll just be sitting there while everybody's still on it. And we'll be enjoying our great days and our car payments and enjoying our vacations. And you'll be sitting there waiting for a while.
But the systems that are in place.
And the systems that are in place have to be fixed. But you know what? They're going to come up with whatever repair system they can. And based astrologically speaking, it's not going away. Like,
yeah, it's shifting. They're maneuvering things. But
everybody gets a hold of me like, oh, how much should I invest in the Iraqi dinar? I go, oh, you really want to go invest something where a bunch of people got killed for some sort of financial thing and none of it worked out? I laughed for years and I put out a prediction in 2012. The Iraqi dinar will not make anybody money. And all those people lost all that money.
Yeah.
Because they don't want to do the hard work of your own financial freedom in any system. It comes to you, not the system against you. And it's you. It's you and your own power. If I can make millions of dollars doing this on a laptop over the years that I've done with not one investor or anything, it's a joke to think that the financial system's creeping you down. Like, it's you. It's your self-worth. It's your own manifesting power. It's not the outer system. Even if it changes, you're going to have to find a way to be successful in there. Even if it's a, you know, a Bernie Sanders system, whatever you want to call it, hypothesized, right? Like, there's still going to be losers and winners in every system. Even in trading, there's going to be losers and winners. That the astrology proves that it will always be that way. Taurus will always represent that somebody has something better than you. Whether or not you're ready to admit that in your life is up to you. And that's going to be the hard part of the next 7 years. Uranus comes into Taurus next year, which rules money. Last time Uranus came into Taurus was when Hitler took power and when the most war machines were made in the world. All the physical aspects and the financial systems were going into extreme. We're about to balloon more than you've ever seen before. So I suggest jump on that train and don't go the other way, because you can really manifest your greatest financial dreams over the next 7 years if you want to do the work. If you want to go against it, see you there. You know, it's funny. Somebody, there was an article today that came out from
I was just going to repeat the question.
Right.
Yes. What is the question?
An example.
An example is somebody going their own way or somebody getting off the system, right? Or staying on the system. So a good example, Business Week today just came out with an article saying, if you are on the 9-to-5 and own a home and on the 401k, you will lose. It was just proven literally this week that it does not make sense anymore. The safe route of the system doesn't make sense. You have to use the system in your own advantage now. Everything is moving towards off of brick and mortar, staying and working for somebody else, like independent financial freedom is what Uranus and Taurus is going to be starting next year. Pluto, Saturn, Jupiter, and Capricorn all dealing with you need to put your bootstraps on and work your butt off and find a way to make it or not. It's going to get to where sink or swim is going to get taller. That's not going away. And the astrology said that years ago. So that's how I already knew Trump would win. I was like, the astrology, the financial system's about to get bigger than it's ever gotten before. And it's not going away. Once we get into Aquarius, the thing that's going to stop it would be electrical disaster or us losing the grid, which is what Pluto coming into Aquarius, that's for different rounds.
Yeah.
But for the next 7 to 8 years, it's going to be sink or swim. And an example would be, you know what, taking a risk. I mean, I wish I could give you more examples of risk, but risk is leaving security. Think about your grandparents in the Depression. Pluto was in the opposite sign of Cancer. All they cared about was staying alive. People now, their concern is what job they have. And oh my God, I can't have that job. What would people think about me if I had that job?
Yeah.
Exactly. So we're living the opposite of what our grandparents went through. And Pluto, have you guys ever seen Pluto's orbit? Remember as kids, remember it goes really close to the sun, then it goes way the fuck out there, and then it comes back close to the sun. So we went through the little loop of where it was from the sun from the 1930s to now, okay? Pluto just went loop, and now it's on its way, gonna go way out far away for a long time. So that means that we went through the fastest loop of Pluto where it could go from half the zodiac in literally less than 100 years, even though it takes 250 years to go around the sun. So the fact that this has happened dealing with Cancer, and for the fact that this is dealing with Capricorn, which will security and the foundation of your financial business, what you're achieving is right now you have to take the biggest risks of your life. If you're trying to hold on with your crabby emotional, oh, I don't want to lose security and safety and I have a kid to feed. You're going to be like, do you guys remember the play, I Gotta Pick a Pocket or Two, Oliver?
Yeah.
You're going to be the mom or dad that's like sitting in Oliver's orphanage trying to pick some pockets to make some, pick a pocket or two to make some money. Like, you got to take risk. Pluto and Saturn and Jupiter are coming in 2018. And I've been, or in 2018 and 2019, but especially Saturn comes into Capricorn in 2018. I hate to be honest with you all. If you guys don't want to take a risk in your life coming up, this is the last 8 months to where you have the freedom to kind of be flexible. The concrete's going to hit. And if you're not willing to take a risk, the universe is, it's going to be sink or swim. And it's coming. And it's just a harsh reality. That's why Capricorn's the harshest sign. That's why Capricorns always get the bad rap. Well, guess where all the planets are coming?
We still love
Capricorn.
You.